If you want to know how to simplify algebraic expressions the easiest way, then stick with me in this lesson as I will be taking you through some series of examples to show you how to simplify algebraic fractions. My name is Justice Johnson, and I want to welcome you to this channel, Maths Fusions. Now, let us get straight into the lesson. From what we have here, you can see, let's take a look at this first example. In this first example, we have m power 3 divided by m power 5. How do we go about this? The very first thing we are going to do, let's write out our equals to, is for you to observe that the two letters are the same, m, m. So check out this first power 3. For you to simplify this or to reduce this to its lowest term, all you have to do is to start with the lowest power, the smallest power, which is 3. And you are going to subtract 3 from 3. The idea is so that we can obtain a 0 in the power, which will now make the index to become 1. So let's get right into what we are doing. So here we can say m power 3 minus 3. And we are going to do the same thing at the denominator. We're also going to say m power 5 minus 3. So that's the first thing we are to do. Subtract the lesser power from both powers there, okay? So now, in the next step, here we are going to write our n power 0 because 3 minus 3 is 0. So write n power 0, then divide by. Then here we are going to write our n power 2 because 5 minus 3 will give us 2. Okay, so what do we do here in the final stage? In the final stage, we are going to write our n power 0 is 1 according to the law of indices, which states that if we are having a 0 index, then the result must be 1. So our n power 0 will turn to 1, and then our n power 2 still remains there. So this is going to be the final answer to this first question. Now let us go into solving this next example. In this second example, we have 32 e power 5 divided by 8e power 2. Okay, so in this case now we are having, let's write our equals to. Let's deal with the numbers first of all, okay? Now if you observe, we're having 32 and 8, which are even numbers. So we come to this side, what are the even numbers? We have 2, 4, 6, 8, and so on. Let us take this first even number and divide 32 and 8. If you divide 32 by 2, okay, you are going to have 16. And if you divide 8 by 2, you are going to have 4. 16 and 4, they are still even numbers, so we can keep dividing by 2. So 2 in 16 will give us 8, and in 4 will give us 2. Let's still keep dividing by 2. 2 will cancel itself 1 and cancel 8, that will give us 4. So which means if we roll our line here, we are going to have 4 as the only number at the denominator, numerator, okay? Now we'll go to the next term, which is your letter. We have e power 5. And if you check at the denominator, the number has now turned to 1 after our cancellation. We are left with e power 2. Now, like we did in example 1, let us consider this particular smaller power, okay? And subtract to turn it to 0, okay? We do the same thing here, subtract to turn it to 0. And if we do this, then in the next level, we are going to have 4e power 5 minus 2 is 3. And then our e minus 2 is our, that is e power 2 minus 2 will give us what? 0. Okay, so you already know what e power 0 is, okay? And then in the next step, we are going to have 4e power what? Power 3. Now, e power 0 is what? 1. So we can leave our result here, okay? So that is how we got the second question. Now, let us take the third question and solve this question the way we did the first two examples. Now, we'll put our equals to. You observe we have numbers, we have 3, we have 9. Now 3, these two numbers are odd numbers, and the first odd number is what? Your 3, which means 3 can cancel itself here, 1, and cancel here what? 3. So we come here, when 3 cancels this, it becomes 1, 3 cancels 9, will give us 3. So here we have 1, then x power 3, then followed by what? Y power 4. Then at the denominator, we have x power what? 7. Because, okay, we have 3x power 7, since there's a 3 here. Then we have y. We have y power what? Power 3. Now, if you check the x, you can see that we're having the same x at the top and bottom. But the smaller power is 3. So here we are going to subtract our 3. And of course, you know the reason why we are doing that. We are subtracting our 3. Then here, the smaller power of y is also 3. We are going to subtract it. Okay. Then in the next step, we rule our line again. Then we have x power 0. Because 3 minus 3 is 0. Then we have y power what? Power 1. Okay. Then at the denominator, we have 3. X power what? 7 minus 3 will give us 4. And then here we have y power 0. Then finally, the final solution here, since we know that x power 0 is 1, then we are going to have just y at the numerator. And then here we have 3x power what? Power 4, because y power 0 is what? Equals to 1. So this is going to be the final solution for this example 3. Now, with these three examples, I'm sure solving this next example, which is the fourth example, wouldn't be a problem for you. Okay, so let us take this example quickly. Now, you already know we have 24 and 18, okay, which are both odd even numbers. And you already know your even numbers. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and so on. Let's start by dividing by what? By 2. 2, we go into 24, 12 times, into 18, we have 9 times. And since we now have a mixture of even and odd number, none of this number here can divide the 9. So we can go to the odd number, which is 3, 5, and so on. Let's start with 3 first. 3 can divide 12, that will give us 4. And 3 can divide 9, that will give us what? 3. So over here, we'll rule our line. At the numerator, the number there is 4. At the denominator, the number is what? Is 3. We can now move on to the letters. At the numerator, we have B power 2. Let's write the B power 2 in the denominator, okay, following alphabetical order. Then we have C. Then this C is C power 1. Y, we have C power 3 at the denominator. Now you realize that since we're having the same letter, B squared and B squared, they can cancel out each other to give us what? 1. Okay. Then we can subtract the lesser power like what we've been doing before. And that will give us the final answer to this question as 4. Then this is C power 0. Let's write it out. C power 0. Then at the denominator we have 3. C power what? Power 2. Okay. Then we can still say this result is going to be equal to C 4 divided by, sorry for that error, we have 4 divided by 3C squared. Okay, so this is the answer to this question. Now, let us take some more examples that are a little bit difficult and different from what we have done so far. Let's start out with this example you can see here. Now, take a look at this. You can see that in this case, we are having a negative power, all right? So the way we dealt with the positive power is going to be slightly different from how we are going to be dealing with what the negative power. So let's start with this first number 5 question. Now, in number 5 question here, we're having 10 and 15, all right? So we look for a number that can divide 10 and 15. That number will be what? Will be 5, because if you check your odd numbers, your 3, 5, and so on, 3, 5, 7, and so on. If you take your 5, 5 can divide 10 to give us 2, and 5 can divide 15 to give us 3. Okay, now the next we do is to consider the letter V. Here we have V power minus 3, and at the denominator, we have V power 2. Now all we have to do is to, first of all, locate the smaller power. In this case, you would agree with me that minus 3 is a smaller power. Now what do we do here? We have to take the inverse of this, that is the opposite of minus 3, which is plus 3. And if we do this, we are going to have 0, okay? Now we come here and also do that to balance up everything, all right? Then we move to the next letter. In the next letter, we have U power 7, and then we also have U power minus 2. Then you can see here that minus 2 is a smaller power. Then we can write it in the opposite form and also come here to put it as plus 2. Now in the next step here, we are going to write the result of what we've done so far. So here we have 2V V power 0 minus 3 plus 3 will give us 0. And then we have U power what? 7 plus 2 will give us 9. Okay, and at the denominator we have 3V power what? 2 plus 3 will give us 5. And then U, then if you subtract this, you are going to have power what? 0. Then eventually, the final answer to this question will become 2, the V power 0 will turn to 1, okay? Then you have 2 U power 9, then divided by 3 V power 5. So that is going to be the final answer to this question. I'm sure you are catching up. Let's quickly take the sixth example in this lesson. And you would agree with me that simplifying or reducing algebraic fractions to its lowest term using this method that I'm using, it's quite easy, all right? So, but let us look at a different example. In this example 6, it's quite different from what we've been doing so far. Here, the letters all carry their own words, respective word power, okay? Now, see what we are going to do here. This power that is outside the bracket 5 is going to be redistributed inside the terms that you see in the bracket. And if you check here, you can see that 7 is outside the bracket, which means this 5 will not affect the 7, all right? So in what we are in the next step here, we roll our line, and then we write our 7, then open the bracket. Then here we use the 5 outside to times the power of y, which in this case is 2. So 2 times 5 will give us 10. So we have y power 10, then the z we have there, the power is what? 1. Okay, so 5 times 1 will give us 5. Then we can still put the bracket, which means this is multiplying into what you have here, right? Now we do the same thing here. You observe that in this case, the 21 is included in the bracket. So which means the minus 2 that is in the power here will also affect the power of this 21. So here we are going to write 21 power minus what? Minus 2. That is, the power of this 21 is 1 times minus what? 2. And that's why you see this, okay? Then you write our y. Then we have minus 3 times minus 2. That will give us what? Plus 6. Then here is z power 1. Like we did before, we are going to multiply out this to give us z power minus 2. So that is what we have here so far. Now the next thing we are going to do is to check the highest power. But before we do that, notice what we have here, the 21 power minus 2. There is no corresponding value for it at the numerator. However, there is, okay, because this 21 power minus 2 has been turned to 1 in the numerator. So we have to write it out by stating it as 21 power 0, okay, to give us 1, all right? So, and then we come to say times 7, then times, don't forget the 7 is distributed into the what? The brackets. So we have y power what? 10. And then we have times z power what? Power 5. Then at the denominator, we have 21 power minus 2. Then y power 6. And then z power what? Minus 2. Okay, now from here, what do we do next? Okay, in the next level here, we are going to add the opposites of minus 2 here and add it here in the power as well, okay? And then don't forget 7 is where it is, so there's no need for us to touch it. We come to what we have here. The lesser power, of course, of y is minus 6, so we have to subtract 6 there and put it up here also, minus 6. Then the lesser power here is plus, is minus 2, so we have plus 2, then we have plus 2. In the next step, we are going to write out the value. So here will become 21 power 0 plus 2. That will give us 21 squared, then times 7, then times y power what? 10 minus 10 minus 6 will give us 4. Okay, then multiplied by z power 7. Then at the denominator, we have 21 power 0, because minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Then times y power 0, then multiply by z power 0. So you can see that all the terms at the denominator are all what? 1, because anything power 0 is 1. So everything at the denominator we cancel out. So, which means the result will be 21 times 7. Let's take our calculator at this point. And in our calculator here, when we turn it, we are going to say 21 squared, then multiply by 7. And the result will be 21 squared, multiply, can see the result, we have 3087. So we'll write it out, 3087. Then if you multiply this, we are going to have y power 4, then z power 7. And this is going to be the final answer for this problem. Now let us take the last example for this lesson. In this last example, it's kind of different from what we have in example 6, because if you check out in example 6, you will see that there is a number outside the bracket, okay? But if you check the numerator here, you see that the number is included in the bracket, and outside the bracket we have in the power. So which means the power will be distributed to all the powers of all the terms you see in the bracket. Now this 5 carries power what? 1. So let's write it out. Do the same thing here. Now please don't make the mistake of cancelling 5 by 5, because you have not yet opened the bracket, okay? You have not yet used this square to expand the bracket. So we need to first do that before we can start cancelling out any common factors. So now, in distributing these 2 into the bracket, we are having 5. 2 times 1 will give us 2, so we have 5 squared. And then, we can rule our line to guide us. Then we have 2 times minus 4, so we have x power what? Minus what? Minus 8. Then here we have y power what? 3 times 2 will give us 6. Okay, now we come to the denominator and we do the same thing. We distribute the negative 3 into the bracket. So 5, so here we have 5, then power 1 times minus 3 will give us minus 3. Then here we have x power 3 times minus 3 will give us minus 9. Then here we have y. Then we have what? 9. 9 times minus 3 will give us minus 27. So that is what we have here. Now, the next step is that we look for the smaller power and then we do our subtraction. So here we say equals to. And we do this. Now, between 5 power 2 and 5 minus power minus 3, you can see that the minus 3 is a lesser power. So we come here, we write 5 power minus 3 plus 3. Then at the top, we add that plus 3 to the power we have there, which is 5 plus 3. Then we have the x. The lesser power of x in this case is minus 9. Okay, so we come, we say minus 8. If you check, we have minus 9. So which means if we add 9 to it, if you turn to 0, then we'll put the 9 here, plus 9. Then at the denominator, we have x power what? Minus 9 plus 9. And the next thing we go into is to write out our y. And if you check, we have minus 27 as a smaller power. So we say 6 minus 27. And then here, don't forget to write it out. We have y about minus 27 plus 27. So which means this place should be positive, not negative, okay? Because it is what we have here that will tell us what we are going to put up here, since we are turning this to zero. All right, so that is what we have here. In the next step, we are going to show how all the values there are simplified. So 5 power 2 plus 3, we add 2 plus 3, that is 5. So we have 5 power 5. Then here we have x power what? Minus 8 plus 9 is x power 1. Then we have y power what? If we subtract this, if we add this up together, you are going to have 33, okay? And then at the denominator, we know we have 5 power what? 0. Then x power 0. Then y power 0. That's what we have. So finally, in this question, all we have to do here, because everything here will be 1, okay? That's at the denominator. So we take our 5 power what? 5 power 5. Now, what is our 5 power 5? If we take our calculator and we take 5 power 5, if you type in the value, 5 power 5, as you can see here, okay, 5 power 5. If we do this, 5 power 5, you are going to have 3, 1, 2, 5, okay, then our x, then y power what, 33. Now, it is not too conventional for us to be writing everything upon 1, so let's just write out the answer simply as 3, 1, 2, 5, x, y power what, 33. So that is how we simplify algebraic fractions to its lowest term. I'm sure you enjoyed this lesson. Please let me know what you think about the method that I used here. Do you think it is okay? Do you think it's quite easy for you to understand? Please share your thoughts with me. And if you have any other idea you would like to share with me, please don't forget to drop it in the comment box. Now, please, if you have not subscribed before, I would like you to subscribe in this channel. And also like and leave a comment, please. And I would like to see you in my next lesson.